inside. Hey.
About time. Forget where your door is.
What's wrong? Is it Tegan?
No, I left my purse here yesterday. Oh, there it is. I imagine if someone saw it. Thought me and you were having a thing. That looked dodgy, wouldn't it? You and Tegan's sister.
Well, you got it now, so...
Oh, listen. Yesterday, when we were here, we found Tegan's phone under that cupboard. And on the day of the accident, she left Kim a really long voicemail.
Saying what?
Well, we don't know. Kim's phone's broke. But she's having it fixed at the Emporium. Hey, have you seen Steve? He didn't come home last night.
No, why would I?
Right, well, if you do see him, tell him the good news. Because this voicemail could hold some answers as to how our Tegan ended up in a coma.
Right, we've got...
You shouldn't have stayed over last night.
You need to calm down, okay? You can't storm around to Kim to this day. She's going to know something's up.
Yeah, well, if Tegan called her, she could find out everything. Do you understand how incriminating that voice message could be?
It's not like you committed a crime or anything, is it? Right, okay, worst case scenario, she's going to know about me and you. Well, guess what? When Tegan wakes up, everyone's going to know about us anyway.
Yeah, but it's not just about us, Steve.
What's that about then?
It's about the kids. I mean, after everything they've been through with Harry, if they find out about us, it's just going to mess their heads up. And if Kim finds out, then... Oh. Hello, DS Knight. Yeah, look, I'm not due until later on. Can I... Okay, I understand. Let's work. They need me in straight away. How am I going to get to Kim's phone?
Well, you can't, but I can.
Wait. We need to listen to the voice message together so we can decide what to tell Leah and Lucas.
I'll sort it.
Have you seen my bag?
Finding Zen. Bag first, Zen later. Oi! I'm trying to zone out. I could hardly sleep thinking about Tegan.
There's nothing you could have done.
Yeah, well, what if she called me for help? What if she never wakes up and I could have done something? I mean, how am I going to live with that?
Wait till you've heard the voicemail. You never know, she might have just pocket called you. Someone was out late last night.
Yeah, I was just talking to Ellie.
Oh, talking, was it? Let me guess. Something like, oh, kiss me again, Sammy. Oh, we've fallen into bed.
It wasn't like that.
Whatever. I really need to find my bag.
What are you doing with Ellie? After the crash, you said she'd stay away.
Yeah, I can't.
So you lied to me. And let me guess, this payback for James isn't over either. I am not keeping this from Farrah again.
No, that's not what this is. Look, Kim, I haven't felt this way for a long time. And if Farrah ever found out, it'd ruin everything.
Is someone...
Come to pick up a phone. Kim Butterfield.
Hiya, Kim. You had a face transplant.
She's a little bit busy, so she asked me to collect it for her.
Well, I'm sorry, I can only give it to the person it belongs to.
She's my mate. Best mate. Listen, my sister's in hospital, you know, and she's very ill. Plus, Kim's having a tough time also, so we could do without the added stress of not being able to contact each other.
Well, the battery took the biggest hit, so I've replaced it and polished up some of the wiring, which was actually quite tricky.
Look, kind of in a rush.
The replacement battery is quite old, so it needs charging for at least a couple of hours.
Can I just have it? Thank you.
Kim?
Why are you stealing my phone?
Steve, give it back to me. Look, I get it, okay? Tegan's your sister and you want to hear what she said, but it's my phone.
Okay. Well, can we listen to the voicemail together then, please? No, I can't wait. He said it needs charging anyway.
Is something going on here?
No, of course not, no.
Then why aren't you handing it over?
I don't want to buy you from the Emporium, but unless you give her a property back.
Fine, here. But you better call me as soon as you've heard it.
Are you breaking for lunch? I need to go home, charge my phone, and I was wondering if you wanted to join me. You alright? I heard you and Sammy talking earlier, and it wasn't about whose turn is it to buy cornflakes. So, do you want to tell me what you're keeping from me?
Don't need to be paranoid.
I'm not getting all paranoid. Sammy literally said it's something I shouldn't find out about. I can't believe I'm asking this. But is something going on between you?
Me and Sammy? You've got to be joking.
Do I look like I'm cracking a joke? But I'm with you. What a stupid thing to suggest.
Not for me, it isn't. The whole time I was growing up, it felt like I was on this endless cycle of falling for girls, getting close to them, idiotically thinking we were onto something, only to realise they were into my brother all along. So, if that's what's happening here, then you need to come clean with me right now.
I wish I could tell you everything, but you just need to trust me.
No, that's not good enough. How can I trust you when you're keeping some kind of secret from me?
I know it sounds silly, but honestly, it is not what you think.
You know what? If we can't be honest with each other, then maybe we shouldn't even be together.
What do you think you're doing here?
We've not answered any calls.
I'm at work. Did you get Kim's phone?
No, she's got it. Just took it home to charge it up. You know what, you might as well just come out. Everyone's going to find out anyway. Look, plus, if you get ahead of the game, you can do it on your own terms.
Look, we're not going through this again, Steve.
I get that it's a big deal. Right, look at me. You're the last person I thought I'd ever have feelings for, but I do. Ryan, I care about you, I don't want you.
What do you think you're doing? Whatever you think this is between us, yeah? It's nothing to me.
Why are you saying that?
Because I'm not like you. I'm not... twisted. Now, if you haven't managed to sort it out with Kim, I'll do it myself.
Farrah thinks you and me are having an affair. I mean, all this time as brother and sister, and she didn't realise I was a bloke.
It's not funny. She's gonna dump me if I don't tell her the truth.
Yeah, well then make something up. Kim, look, no good can come from her knowing about me trying to get back at James. It'll cause her too much grief.
Well, maybe you shouldn't have done it in the first place, then. Look, I know your vendetta against James isn't exactly going to go down well with your family, but I'm not going to lie to her anymore.
Kim, please. Look, if you really love Farrah, you'll protect her from this.
You mean protect you? She's my girlfriend, and she deserves to know the facts. I'm telling her tonight.
It's Steve. What, if you listen to this, then you've obviously heard Tegan's voicemail. Look, I'd love to chat to you back, so can you give me a call as soon as you get this?
So, I heard Tegan left you a voice message. I know it sounds really pathetic, but I was just wondering if I could listen to it first.
It needs to be plugged in for a bit longer. It's not fully charged yet.
Well, I'll just wait until it's ready, if you don't mind.
Look, it's not my house. I don't really feel comfortable having guests here when everybody's out.
Look, please, Kim, I love Tegan so much, and I just really need to hear her voice again. You get that, right?
Yeah. I'll call you, I promise.
The phone is charged.
I know that you killed Amy. What did you do to Tegan?
You should never have heard this.
Heard about that voicemail. Has there been any news from Kim?
Nothing. Steve, I just feel like the whole family's just falling apart. Perry, she can't even look at me. And Tegan, I want her to wake up and just bring us all back together.
Me too.